Climbing the retirement mountain. Have you thought of retirement being a mountain that has to be climbed? Well, here are some parallels between mountain climbing and retirement mountain climbing. And I'm doing this pretty heartbroken. This must be the first monsoon in so many years, maybe 20 years, that I have not gone on a single trek, not even a walk on the mountains during the rains. Terrible. Anyway, we are talking of the retirement mountain. How do you climb a mountain, or rather, how do you go on a difficult trek? Maybe with a group of friends or alone. All alone is really difficult, but yes, you do. Sometimes you're forced to go all alone if the others have decided to come later or go earlier, right? So how do you go? First is you have to internally feel that you're ready for the mountain and you're, and the mountain is calling you, right? If you don't have that internal feeling, whether you're climbing on the Sahyadris or climbing Valley of Flowers or Hemkund Sahib, doesn't matter. Whether it's a small 4 kilometer trek in for Flower Valley, which will take you 7 hours or 5 hours, just 4 kilometers, you can't believe this, right? So that is the kind of trek. So mountaineering also, or climbing the retirement mountain also, is like that. Some parts of the mountain climbing could be very easy, and some 4 kilometers could take 5 hours or 7 hours, right? Both of that happen. So first is you should have an internal feeling that you should take up the journey. No amount of outside coercing will happen. Anybody outside who is trying to tell this 32-year-old that he should start saving, or telling this 26-year-old that he or she should start saving, will not work. It has to, the voice has to come from inside saying, yes, it is time that I started climbing the mountain and I want to do it. And of course, you will do it alone. So the minute you decide on that, you need a plan. You can't do a mountain climbing without a plan. That plan need not be written down. If it's a big group and you're just part of the group, you just have to follow the group. You don't really have to do anything for that, except carry your own supplies and rations, etc., and make sure that you are there with the team at the time when they are planning to leave. So for that, you will need a plan and you will work as per the plan. So once you decide to climb the mountain, you reach the bottom of the mountain, you will need a route and you will have to fix yourself on the route. Now this is somewhat like religion also. Every religion says ours is the best route. Now that is necessary, because man otherwise would go and try every route and not actually climb at all. So it's necessary to find your route and say, this is the route which I am going to climb, which I am going to use to go to the top of the mountain. Right? So question is, you're prepared for the journey, you've gone there with your group, you've reached there, now you have to have your plan from with which you're going to climb the mountain. Sorry to do a plug-in, but if you don't have a plan, getting retire rich, invest rupees 40 a day, this book makes sense. It's a good blueprint to your retirement plan. I mean, you call it mountaineering or whatever. From now, you have your plan in your head or written down. Now concentrate on the plan. Concentrate on how you're going to go, how each step is going to be. Think about it, visualize, and start the journey. It's a dull, boring journey, whether you're doing it alone or whether you're doing it with friends. But then, yes, the path begins, and the path is tough. The road is narrow, sometimes cracked, and if you're even in Sahyadri, sometimes it's raining, so you will slip. Make sure you've got very good foot gear. If you've got a staff, that's very good, wooden staff or plastic, it's available in good shops to hold a, have a grip on what you are, where you're climbing. Many places it's crooked. It definitely slips in some places, so be careful about all that. You will have a lot of distractions. Do not lose focus. Find many other friends and who are all climbing there. Find the opportunity to chat with them, talk with them, and slow and steady you start, and understand that the bigger that is a gap between spending and the income that you have, the greater is the amount that you will be able to save, stroke, invest, and do well after a particular point in time. There may be a few changes here and there, but the basic rules remain the same. And also remember, while on the way up also, one slip and you could just be at the bottom of the mountain, right? So the journey is narrow, it is confront with the nature, it slips. If there is rain, it is even worse. It feels chilly, it feels cold, but there is fun in doing it. That is exactly why we do it. Why do we climb the mountain? Just because there is a mountain there saying, please climb me, right? It is as simple as that. Then we also remember that we need rest breaks, we need loo breaks. But remember, it should not be for too long, because if it is for too long, then the human body loves to be in that state of inertia and it will refuse to move. So don't get to sleep. So similarly, while in your retirement planning, don't say I will take 2 years leave or 3 years leave. It does not work that way. You need to be investing regularly on a monthly basis. Even if you have quit your job and you're doing your own work, yes, you can't put 1 lakh per month, you can't put 2 lakhs per month, but you can put 1,000 per month during that period. Just keep it going. That is important, because even if you're carrying food supplies and all, there will sometime be tremendous amount of tiredness and inertia, and you will feel like just not doing anything, just throwing up and sitting there. That doesn't work. You have to work at it relentlessly and make sure that you are achieving what you have sought out to achieve, largely achieving your retirement goal. You have climbed the mountains, you have reached the top, you're sitting there, and that's fine. You got your friends there, everything has happened. Is that the end? Well, the journey is exactly half done. Like the ISRO astronaut story, maybe in 66 itself or 64 itself, Robert Kennedy knew, John Kennedy knew how the man is to be put in the moon, but he wanted to be sure that they got enough apparatus to bring him down back, right? That's important. You cannot put a man there and say, I don't know how he will come back, right? You have to make sure that he comes back. Now you have to start the descending journey, and remember, descending journey in case of mountains is far more tricky than the way up. If you are following the regular path, you may not have a problem, but if you are using shortcuts, etc., you may have a problem of knowing the place well. You have to carry your backpack. You won't find somebody else to carry your 20 kilos. In case you don't have any equipment, make sure that you can stitch it up, right? Do all those things. Sometimes you need the help of a planner like a Sherpa, who will be able to carry some of your things, right? Then remember, it is your retirement journey. Don't compare yourself to somebody else who is walking faster or much faster, or somebody who is running. It is their problem. Their problem to attend to it, their problem to talk about it, right? You relax. Thank you.